من حسن ظریف ناظریان هستم که به مدت 12 سال در زندان‌های جمشیدیه، اوین و قزلسار بودم.
I am Hassan Zarif Nazarian. I was in Jamshidia, Evin, and Ghazalhesar prisons for 12 years. I was in Evin prison at the time of the 1988 massacre. I have had many interviews about the 1988 massacre in the past years, and I have covered some aspects of the issue. But today, I want to point out the less discussed aspect in this interview. What has been said about the 1988 massacre in various interviews by various witnesses are about Evin and Gohardasht prisons only, and their observations in the death corridor in Gohardasht and the central hall in these two prisons. However, not much is said about other prisons in the country, including Vakilabad in Mashhad, Adelabad, Karun, UNESCO, in various prisons in the country. What happened in those prisons remain a secret. Apart from this, there are other issues. In addition to the massacre and killing of those inside the prisons, others were also subjected to this massacre and were executed at the same time. Among them were prisoners who had been released more or less 1 or 2 years before the massacre. They were also arrested and executed. Anyway, first I want to talk about two lists. One list is a list of 170 types of tortures and inhumane acts exercised and perpetuated in the regime's judiciary and prisons. The other list includes 877 people who were massacred in Evin and Gohardasht prisons during the 1988 massacre. Of course, I will explain how and under what conditions these lists were prepared and why they are not complete. Following the massacre, it was decided that Mr. Galindo Pol, the UN Special Representative, would visit Iran's prisons. At this time, I thought that if we could get some of the names of those executed to Galindo Pol, he would have a much better hand in inquiring about the case. Why? Because at the time, Khomeini's regime entirely denied the massacre. They did not agree to enter any discussion about the massacre.
تلاش کردم به همراه دوستان همبندیم مثل حسین فارسی، مهرداد کاووسی، علیرضا طاهرلو اون هم مخفیانه اون هم در پوشش.
So I tried to secretly compile these lists with my cellmates including حسین فارسی، مهرداد کاووسی and علیرضا طاهرلو out of the two prisons of Evin in Gohardasht, there are only about 250 people left who are not executed, and we were all put in one ward. We tried to collect the statistics of those executed in those wards by referring to people who had remained from different wards.
ما در بندمون 175 نفر بودیم
As for Evin prison, especially in Ward 1, where I was kept previously, there were 175 of us in that ward, of whom only 15 survived the massacre. There was a ward called the Life Sentenced Ward, which used to have about 160 prisoners. Of these, 8 or 9 survived. Ward 2 of Evin, that is, of the total lower and upper sections of that ward, which had about 250 political prisoners, about 15 survived. From the upper ward, number 4, which had about 150 political prisoners, 8 survived. All 6 of the ward called school, 104 political prisoners were kept, 100 were executed, and only 4 survived. All 4 of the school had about 40 political prisoners, of whom only 6 survived.
البته در اوین دو بند دیگه ای بود مخصوص زنان زندانیان سیاسی زن که اینا آمارشون حدود 300 نفر به بالا بود.
Of course, there were 2 other wards in Evin that were reserved for female political prisoners. There were about 300 plus. We did not contact them, but their relatives, such as their brothers or spouse, who were in our wards, could get information about their sisters or spouse in meetings they had inside prison. We found that most of these political prisoners in the women's wards were executed, and only a few remained.
برحال این موضوعی بود که ما اشراف کلی خود من نسبت به اوین داشتیم.
Anyway, this was the general information that I had about Evin prison. The main problem was compiling a list of prisoners who were executed in Gohardasht prison. Let me mention here that we had 14 wards in Evin prison, added by 2 wards which were solitary confinements. From all these 16 wards, we were only able to collect the names of those executed in 5 wards only, and did not have access to the rest.
در گوهردشت. گوهردشت 24 بند داره. اینکه چند تاش پر بود، چند تاش خالی بود.
Gohardasht prison had 24 wards. We do not know how populated these wards were and whether they were full. There was not enough information available. But we knew it had 3 general wards and 21 solitary confinement wards. From the survivors of these wards, we were only able to collect the names of 9 wards. That is, we do not know how many were in other wards. For example, most political prisoners were kept as exiles in Karaj prison. Some had been sent into exile from Mashhad prison to Gohardasht prison. There was a section called the subsection of the Mashhadis for prisoners sent to exile from Mashhad prison. Subsection called Kerman Shahis for prisoners sent to exile for Kerman Shah prison. We do not know whether there were others in exiles from other cities or not.
به همین دلیل بود که میخواستم بگم یک گستره ای از اعدام بوده که ما تونستیم از کل این مجموعه این لیستی رو که اشاره کردم فقط اسامی 800
That is why I wanted to stress that the executions extended to vast areas and prisons, that we could only get the names of 177 prisoners. When I was released from prison, I was able to find the names of about 306 other prisoners. I wrote a memoir called The Secret to Perseverance, in which I have covered all of these issues. But I just wanted to point out that in the 1988 massacre is not just about those who were in prison at the time and were executed. The massacre included those who were already released, soldiers who were arrested. What was the cause? The reason was They wanted to destroy the MEK. Before the massacre, the henchmen told us in many occasions that the leadership and the hierarchy of all the opposition groups had been destroyed, and they had no leadership. And there is only the MEK, which is coherent, and it had its leadership and has kept its structure. And that is why the MEK is considered a threat to the Islamic Republic. They say that we would not allow the MEK to have a foothold in the country. Released prisoners, incarcerated prisoners, and their families are all considered a threat and must be destroyed. These measures were not only related to August 1988, it had started before that. This is why I had to emphasize that the 1988 massacre had nothing to do with the Eternal Lights offensive. The regime's goal was to destroy the MEK and their organization because they were considered to be an existential threat. That is why the massacre did not end and has continued. The massacre is not over. After the 1988 massacre, many, for instance, the Aryan group in Karaj, were executed under the guise of ordinary prisoners, and this continues. All in all, I would like to say that the 1988 massacre was to destroy a generation, to demolish the foothold of the MEK. That is why I want to say that the dimensions of this massacre remain hidden. We still do not have all the news of the massacre from the prisons scattered all over the country. We only know that there are mass graves that are going through changes by the regime. They want to eliminate their trace of their crimes. But the list of victims will be completed before this regime will be gone. The Iranian resistance has managed to compile the names and prisoners of some 5,000 political prisoners executed during the 1988 massacre. Let's see how many more names we will succeed to gather in the path of shedding light on the dimensions of this massacre.